A few short stories by Marshal P. Wilder, Edison Records. It's the hardest thing in the world to get new stories. It keeps you very busy. About as busy as a friend of mine who's only got one arm, but he's got the prickly heat. And then, of course, humor theories. Sometimes, I've often thought if it rained humor, some people would use an umbrella. I gather my material on the different thoroughfares, like 8th Avenue, for example. I went down the other day down 8th Avenue. I saw a sign outside of one of the stores. It read on the sign, "Don't go elsewhere and get cheated. Come in here." So I walked in. A Negro came along and says, "I'd like to get a razor." The clerk said, "What for? Shaving purposes?" Says, "No, sir. Social." I followed this Negro out and met another friend of his. Says, "I do, Tommy," says first thing. Says, "Why don't you join the army of the Lord?" He says, "I do belong to the army. I belong to First Baptist Church." He says, "That ain't the army. That's the Navy." You know, the dog, he gives us a lot of humor. Over here in Jamaica, a friend of mine has got a chicken farm right near him setting. Boss, he misses a bird now and then. So he put a bell outside from the chicken coop to ring at the proper time. The other night, about midnight, this bell went off. He went out the shotgun, stuck it in the chicken coop, said, "Anybody in here?" Scared Negro said, "Only our chickens." Speaking of birds, I happened in the other day into a bird store. But an old Irishman came along. He came in there. He said, "I want some seeds for a cuckoo clock." Notice that I laughed at his remark. He looked me all over and saw my peculiar figure. He said, "Fair young fella, what made you that way?" Well, I said I was carrying a mortgage. Speaking of my size, when I first started in the medical profession years ago, I was out down Connecticut somewhere. It was a custom those days for the committee to come down to welcome me at the depot. Very pleasant habit. Two members of the committee were at the depot to welcome me. They'd never seen me, but they'd heard of me. And they saw the name, rather long. Imagine that a long man went with it. No one got off the train but myself. They stood there, seemed disappointed. One friend said to his pal, said, "Well, I guess he ain't here. No one got off the train but the little boy. Guess he ain't here." I came along. I said, "This is Mr. Jones." He said, "Yes." He said, "My name is Wilder." "Oh, is this your name, Wilder? Well, where's your father?" You know, speaking of my size, the other day I was walking down the street with Mr. Corbett, James J. Corbett, the tutor. Two young ladies came along and they saw us. But one young lady said, "Why, that's James J. Corbett." The other one said, "Good fun." I was giving entertainments out west, got as far as Denver. One of the papers there in town, local papers, spoke kind of the fact I was there, said Marshal P. Wilder's in town. They've always understood that Wilder was a self-made man. But from looking at him, evidently didn't take time to finish the job. I was giving entertainments in that town for some time. Finally, one day, I was walking along the street, an old doctor came up to me and said, "Mr. Wilder?" Said, "I'd like to go in and see your entertainment, but I got no money except this dog. I'll give you the dog and let me go in." "Well," I said, "I don't want your dog. Take your dog in with you." He says, "Can I take him in?" I said, "Yes." I saw him after the entertainment. I said, "Well, how'd you like my show?" "Well," he said, "I'm glad I kept my dog.